Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the first episode of what I hope to be a wonderful new series, at least for me, on my YouTube channel and my Twitch channel, where I'm a kitty, and you, the audience, explore Darkest Dungeon and several other games, and hopefully have a lot of fun and entertainment while doing so. Today we're going to be playing Darkest Dungeon. This is the latest patch 8920 to date. Today is June 3rd, and the brand new Arbalest and Man-At-Arms have been released, as well as additional bosses and additional items and many other things that were changed to make the game even more challenging. Previous to this patch, I have been mostly doing dark runs where there are no torches. The torches are pretty much non-existent, really, and light level zero, just to get more treasures out of the runs. But I tried to do that with my most superior four-man group, but my second one, the one that I was doing all the rank 3 and 4 missions that my rank 6 group didn't want to do, and I lost all of them by the third creature battle, because I turned off the torch right at the beginning, which is new addition, a new change that they've done, where you can now snuff out the torch a little bit or completely with just a push of a button. And as I said, I lost my entire group, so it's quite obvious that it's incredibly riskier now to try and do a completely dark run, unless you come fully prepared with completely satisfactory skills and heroes and trinkets. They've done a very large changes to the trinkets as well, but seeing as how this is a brand new run, this is week one, I have not gone anywhere yet. As you can see here, I have just been escorted to the hamlet, and I haven't gone anywhere yet. I just upgraded my stagecoach a little bit. And yeah, let's go ahead and explore the ruins
of madness and morbidity. Your work begins.
I am going to do this series, or at least these first couple of episodes, with a lot of narration and explanation of what I'm doing. But seeing as how also this is very new to me, I hope that you'll forgive me if I'm not going to do a how-to per se of what I'm doing. So what I mean by that is I'll try to explain why I'm doing certain things, but I'm not going to go into very large detail, just so that they could kind of keep the video going. Because as you can see, the video's been going for what I would assume is 3 to 4 minutes now, and we haven't even gone into a dungeon yet. So I'll go ahead, shut up, and let us start. I forgot, there's no need for anti-venom in the runes. Let's go ahead and I'll just take 2 torches. I'll probably be able to kind of let the light levels decrease as we near the end of the run, and hopefully just a little bit increase the amount of treasure that we get.
And what better place to begin than the seat of our
another nice thing is that they've done in the last patch that I really appreciate is, as you can see, the mini map stays centered on where the party is, respective to the dungeon itself. So there's no more need to constantly manually move the map around or center it. It does that automatically at this point, which is fantastic, and it's just a minor but appreciated quality of life addition to the game. no action so far. Wow, that was a lot happening in that one little movement. Hit a trap, torch fell below 50. No battles so far. Now, one thing that I'm thinking, I don't really know if this would work out or not, but now that I can manually reduce the torch levels, I'm thinking that when it comes down to interactive items that I have the items for, and I know I'll get jewels or I'll call them artifacts because I can't for the life of me remember the appropriate name for that particular type of items. I'm thinking, if I really don't care that much about the light levels, why not decrease light, snuff out the torch completely, interact with the object.
Black as death.
Holy mother. And now I just kick light back up. And by all means, you know, I wasted quote unquote two torches there, which is 150 gold, and more than paid back for it. So, doesn't seem like too bad of an idea. We'll see if this is actually going to be doable in the other upcoming dungeons. And it's really starting to appear as if, like almost instantly the traps are triggered by the reduced light, which I know is not correct, but it just seems that way. Which is amusing. Now, monster, I can't remember, but I think that they increase the amount of damage overall that monsters deal as the darkness levels go lower and lower. Which, again, definitely something that makes the game more challenging. Again, in dark levels, they reduced, I think, the amount of crits that are obtained. I'm not sure. But overall, the game's just become more challenging. Some of the trinkets that we'll get, I've seen some trinkets that are quote unquote new in terms of functionality, what they do, the skills or effects that they give, or buff. And thankfully, the tooltips appear to be a little more straightforward. So, all in all, okay, he, I think, should die. I think, if I remember correctly, that's light 3. Yeah, okay, so he's dead next level. And I don't actually need to patch him up because I actually thought I clicked on Spike. So because with him, I don't know if it's still available at rank 3. I mean 2. Position 2, I'm sorry. But he could remove the bleed off of him, but I don't know if it's really even worth it. Because it's such a weak... Oh wait, no. No, it's a two damage per round for 3 rounds. Or 2 for 2 rounds, 1 for 1 round, but
the bigger the beast, the greater the glory.
It's definitely worth it, and of course I can. I'll just move him anyway. Unfortunately, cannot remove that bleed for free.
No quarter.
I do have a bandage, but I'm not gonna use it because at this point he'll just take 3 more damage. I keep forgetting which ones, because there's other unlocked, quote-unquote, chests, but the key actually unlocks a hidden compartment, and I think that's actually the heirloom chests. So I gotta remember that one. That the unlocked strong box is unlocked for a reason. So that was my mistake, sorry about that. As you can see, I usually just let the torch run out. Damn it. Okay, at this point, I think it's just far too risky to not have light, considering the amount of stress I just took. This is a short dungeon, but unfortunately, I've been running so many. I've been running the same corridors twice, which resulted with me running through my food very damn quickly. Alright, this is good. How often I'm surprising the monsters. Even though the fact that I surprised the last group in a rather dark scenario. What's your dodge? And to resist the debuff, no big deal. We're gonna try and shuffle her to the front. Great. He has a chance to kill her outright, but is it just more worth it to go for the safe thing? And I say yes. Thing is that I generally heals for one. Oh, why not? Generally, I enjoy using AoE abilities during games, be it MMORPG games. MOBA games, things of that nature, because I get the feeling to get more control over the battle with more area of effect. But the problem is that in this game, it's almost always the better choice to eliminate whether the backline or the front line, but have a single unit focused down. Wow, I failed to unbleed him. But I crit on the 1-1 heal, which is just fantastic. What else could I ask for? Other than maybe actually having him on blood, or whatever you want to call it.
These nightmarish creatures can be felled. They can be beaten. Finding the stuff is only the first test. Now it must be carried home.
So yeah, in this game, it's just far more better, in my opinion, to take down a single target. So if you consider the amount of quote-unquote moves or attacks per turn, if you're 4 against 4, that's 4 moves for each side. But once you start reducing the enemy team, your turn arrives more quickly, and you take less damage in between the downtime of your own turn. So with these weak enemies, it's just, at this point, it's better to use AoE attacks and just try to tear them down as fast as possible. I am going to heal instead of attack, because honestly I think that the benefits are much greater in terms of healing rather than having her attack. Because I do have the AoE attacks to work them down. That is a lot of books. Another thing, if this is the first video you're watching ever since the patch came in, and the patch came in at, I think, the last day of May or the first day of June, something like that. Notice how the stress levels no longer max out at 100, it is now 200. So affliction still occurs at, a chance for affliction still occurs at stress 100, but stress 200 actually, the new stress maximum allows your heroes to continue building stress past 100 until the point. I'm going to try and go for the backline here first, A, because they're easier to take down, and B, because they're stress builders, and I'm about to go to town. This is the last fight, so I don't care about health as nearly as much stress at the moment. And just generally speaking, it's better to go for the backline. Anyway, sorry for stopping whatever I was saying before. Now that the stress can build up past 100, and that happens normally, it's not at an increased or decreased rate as far as I know, or as far as I can tell, but once the stress hits 200, the heroes will succumb. At the moment, there's no chance for it. It just happens. The moment your hero reaches stress 200, the hero dies of a heart attack. The heroes just cannot take it no more. And no matter if they're 100 health, no health, well, death's door, whatever, they will die, guaranteed, of a heart attack. There's no way to rescue them. There's no way to save them if you finish the battle quickly. They just die, which is actually what I lost all three of my... if you recall the beginning of the video, I talked about my group on my other game. And the reason you didn't see the save on this particular game when I started it is because I just fixed this computer recently. The cooling system broke and the parts only came in yesterday after 5-6 months of waiting, because the warranty hasn't gone out. Don't you just love that? Yeah, your warranty hasn't gone out and you paid for this thing and it broke after 2 months? Sure, we'll take 6 months to replace it without telling you when it'll come back. I was literally, like, in less than a week, I was going to just give up and go to the store and buy a new liquid cooling system. But anywho, my other group, it was an abuse group. It's a special thing I actually read as a suggestion or fun thing to do for your second party, not your main party, because it's a very risky thing to do. But pretty much abusers, they don't... a hero that's been afflicted with abuse will not cower away and pass a turn. They won't hurt themselves. The only thing they'll do is they'll shout at others and increase the other party members' stress levels. And before the patch, when stress maxed it out to 100, it didn't matter really if they had increased stress modifiers and darkness or whatnot. It didn't matter what kind of negative perks they had. It didn't matter who was shouting at them, because they were already stressed. They were afflicted and they were at 100. And you just never recover them. You never bother paying to have them recovered in town. And the idea behind it is that, yeah, some of the stats are lowered, but the main benefit actually is having... buff is that? I'm kind of curious. 10 accuracy, 10 crit. This expedition, holy mama, at least that is a success. Wow. I think this just gives me buff, right? Removed the quirk. I forgot. Sweet. All right. Not bad at all. Room by room. So the idea in a team that is full of abusers is that each one of them has a plus 20% damage, which is pretty big when you're talking about the way that the game calculates the percent damage added, because you're talking about heroes like the Highwayman that have the grape shot. The plus 20% is actually to each shot, not to the overall skill's damage. So the skill itself, I'll go here to the skill just so that it can help a little bit. And this is, again, just something I read. I don't consider myself an expert in these games or knowing things or figuring these things out. I just read a little bit here and there. But as you see, the damage modification per shot is negative 50%. So if my damage is 10-10, the damage will drop off to 5-5. But the thing is that if this Highwayman gets plus 20% damage, the damage will then go damage modification negative 30. So then a 10-10 base damage would actually drop off to 7-7. So overall, that's actually, you take the amount of units that get hit, which in this case is 3, and multiply them by the damage modification, which will then be actually plus 60% overall damage. So that's why for heroes like him, heroes like the... I'm completely forgetting her name. Maybe she's here? Yeah, there we go. The Helion. All of these multi-attacks would get... There. All these... Actually, what am I talking about? But these multi-attacks, at the very least, would be a little buffed, and you'd be able to shred through groups of enemies a little faster. Not to mention that these base abilities, the really strong ones that hit single target, also are, of course, increased by that plus 20%. I have not had a chance to look at the Man-At-Arms whatsoever. I haven't bothered looking. I didn't want to spoil anything for myself, so I didn't read any of the camping skills, any of the actual abilities he has here. So let's take a look just real quick. Well, certainly let's go ahead and pick each one of these up.
Gold gleams like a dagger's
point.
Let's
upgrade this kit. Oh man, can't upgrade it further right now. Upgrading it to network level 3 or 4 is usually preferred as early as possible, so you have the largest variety of heroes to choose from. I unlock the tavern, okay.
Fresh kegs, cards, and curtained rooms promise solace to the weary and broken alike.
What's she got? Speed, healing percent. Okay, so this is obviously something to keep in mind with abilities like Chant. And Wound Care definitely is another one that'll add an additional, what? I'm going to consider this the same as the plus 20% damage, so that's not plus 15% of the 20%, it's plus 15% to the 20%. So I'm going to assume that this is actually plus 35% heal, and this is actually plus 30% heal if religious, and plus 20 if not. I'm gonna go with it, we'll find out later. But again, this is actually something I do not recall seeing before. I think Stout may have been something else before the patch. If someone could maybe write in the comments and let me know. I can't quite recall. But this is actually, to me, it makes me very happy because I realize that this may mean that there is an additional quirk, and probably a negative quirk as well, that increases or decreases the power of general healing skills. And I know I've seen it on the Crusader in the other save I have, where the Crusader actually had an ability that just had plus 15 or 20% to healing skills, period. And now his healing skills aren't exactly his forte, but you know, if the Vestal or gets it and use Divine Comfort, which I think at max level gives plus 33, I mean, is 3-3 party heal or 4-4, I don't quite remember, but that means that you know, you could be seeing some very large increases in healing, especially if you're looking at the Occultist. You get that plus 20%, and I think it's a heal of 0 to 20, or what is it? You can upgrade it 5 times, I think. So yeah, 5 or 6 times. Let me take a look here. Oh, yeah, I can't actually quite check it in the guild.
The cobwebs,
but anyway, I digress. Anyway, what we wanted to do
the abbey called
is
to the
look
faithful.
At Man of Armor, Man-At-Arms here. Oh no, my ranged skills on a melee hero. Does he have any ranged skills? Let's take a look. No, he has none. So this is actually really good. This negative quirk has taken up a slot here, because if I do end up using him in the future and the negative quirks start maxing out, this would be taking up a slot where a quirk that actually has an effect could take its place, like minus 10% health or something like that. Anyway, alright, so just a couple of bonuses for particular regions. Large base HP, let's see what it is compared to the level 1 Crusader. So, yeah, let's see. Damage, he's actually a little faster. Interesting. Another thing that was changed or added in the last patch is there are now a lot more quirks and trinkets that affect the chance to become virtuous or afflicted when reaching 100 stress. So again, just the nature of the game, I feel, hasn't changed, but the way that your characters are affected within the game, I think, has been modified significantly in terms of risks of heart attacks, darkness being far more challenging, and virtue and affliction becoming much more problematic or easier to deal with, whichever trinkets and quirks you happen to have. So let's see, just a basic attack from position 1 to 2 onto a position 1 to 3 with 5% crit modification. That's really nice. Okay, just wanted to compare real quick the accuracy with other heroes, and there is none at the moment. But I wanted to see, because 85 is not bad at all, yeah. Let's take a look. Rampart makes him move forward one slot, one position, damage is halved, 5% crit modification, and it knocks the target back one and stuns as well. Wow, this is one hell of an ability if used on like a unit that's in position 2 or position 3, knocking it back even further. Usually the position 1 and 2 characters on the enemy don't have too many abilities to use in a position 3 or position 4. So Bella ranged, oh this is ranged attack, so excuse me, the only ranged attack he has, 90% damage reduction, and it reduces the enemy's speed by 5, dodge by 5. Not bad. Alright, so again, it doesn't matter if I have this ability, because at the end of the day, this is not meant to deal damage, which is great. Guard ally. I do not recall what this is. If I am going to guess, I'll assume that it redirects damage. That's going to be my guess. We'll find out. And if that is the case, then that is one hell of an ability. You put that on one of the backline heroes, like an occultist or a highwayman or the Vestal, and man, you're looking at a very difficult to kill backline, but again, we'll have to find out. Marks target and activates riposte. If I only know what that is. See, again, this is a word that I encountered a lot during the patch notes. Riposte. Sorry, I'm foreign, as you can tell by my accent, so sometimes I have challenges with these words, but I'm not quite sure what it does. I remember an ability with riposte in the description from League of Legends. Fiora had it, if I remember correctly, and it would reflect, but I can't remember if actually that's the word parry that was in the description or not. But again, maybe we'll find out. Hopefully it's something that's just very easy to notice. Gives the target 5 accuracy, so I could see him being paired with a leper, or just generally giving buffs to some of the other heroes that you can rely on for damage but don't have the best accuracy. And bolster, wow, okay, so this is pretty much the equivalent of a cleric from, say, League of Legends, not League of Legends, sorry, Diablo, or other kind of games. So this is a support tank buff class. He doesn't seem to really have, yeah, he's just buffs all around and very weak damaging in terms of the amount of abilities that actually deal significant damage, which is really only 2. This ability deals 60%, this ability deals 100%, but just generally speaking, these buffs definitely are going to be very interesting to use. If you'll excuse me, I'm going to go ahead and take a drink. We already recruited everyone. I don't quite know if I want to go ahead and bother spending gold on their rehabilitation. I think I'm going to count on my occultist for healing. I know this is something that there's a lot of stipulation about, and I gotta actually confirm it for myself, because this quirk specifically says negative 10% damage if the torch is below zero. But does that mean that if the torch is zero, meaning the torch is completely snuffed out, this technically takes effect? Because below zero is not less than or equal to zero. So sometimes this game likes to sometimes this game likes to play tricks. Oh, this is a phenomenal item for a leper. Thing is that I don't often use lepers, actually. And the thing is that right now I'm just trying to think of what I want to get in terms of these reward items, because this actually looks like the most unique item in terms of what you can really do with it. The only thing is that you gotta remember to unequip it at the end so that your character doesn't lose out in the experience, because that's something very easy to do. You equip it at the beginning, have the entire run with it, last map, right before you click on finish quest, you have to remember to unequip it, and that's gonna be a challenge, but let's go ahead and try it anyway. Let's see, what's he got? Or she? I don't remember. If the grave robber is a girl, I'm gonna say yes by the dress ish and figure rather than some sort of stealthy assassin looking man. I'd say this is girl. Wait, doesn't it have a description somewhere of the character? I feel like I'm forgetting some of this. Like, where is it? Eh, whatever, who knows. I think it's a girl. I'll go with the girl. Or a really womanly looking man. I mean, look at those lips, right? Anyway. Okay, we want the occultist. What is his bleed resistance, this man at arms? 40%, 40%, 40, 30. Okay, yeah, definitely not these guys. Let's take him for damage and. Let's see what we got. Yeah, okay, so this would actually work out pretty nicely. So we have ways of hitting it. Sorry about that. I don't know if I just touched my microphone or not. So yeah, we can take out the enemy backline with her and Highwaymen. We have ways of reaching the backline. And I don't really see myself using the vulnerability hex unless there's some really high dodge enemy. I usually use him with, what's the name of that hero? It's not the Highwayman, because I have that in my party. The one, the bandit, I think? I don't remember. The one that has the melee axe ability that gets 100% additional damage if the target is marked. I'm not gonna go for the same thing that happened to me before, where I had a really badly made map and I ended up burning through. I needed to burn through 12 food on a small map. So I'm going to go ahead and significantly increase the amount of food I have. Let's go ahead and take a lot of torches so that we can mess around with light levels. We'll do that. This isn't too much when you think about the treasure that you could actually get with it. We'll take some of these. I'm just gonna go all out here because this is medium size. This is really early on, and I'd much rather toss a couple of these away and waste 500 gold than miss out on a ruby or two, you know, and lose several thousand gold. And especially, okay, so let's take a look. This is not too bad of a map. I'll have to traverse a couple corridors over, but I'll be able to camp in the middle. So they're all almost at half health.
Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
So let's see, let's do guard on her. Let's see what that does. So guarded by Ligonier. I'm gonna change those names anyway. And he has 6 protection. Now, if I recall, a quick explanation of what percentage of protection is real quick. Protection here is 20% and he's getting 6 protection. What I read, because there's been a lot of confusion amongst... I gotta fuse this anyway. How much damage? 1 to 2. Alright. Big hit. Big hit. Crit on that ability is actually incredibly high.
Press this advantage.
But anyway.
Give them no quarter.
Protection. Okay, so it lasts just one turn, so it's not overpowered. Or it doesn't seem overpowered. It would definitely be overpowered if you could put it on like one of your supports and then have him constantly attack afterwards. Alright. Oh, great. Alright. What you got? It didn't say? Okay, I'm very confused. It didn't give him negative stress. It showed negative quirk, and there are no negative quirks. Maybe it gave him the same negative quirk? I don't know.
Even the cold
stone. I didn't get shovels because I'm an idiot. This is gonna hurt bad. Oh man, I fucked up. Sorry.
The light, the promise of safety.
Great. Anyway, so if you have, let's say, you know, I'll just give some arbitrary numbers to make the explanation simpler. If you have 100 health unit, and that unit uses a 10% protection ability or has a 10% protection quirk, the percentage is taken from the health, so 10% of 100 health is 10. And then that amount of protection, those 10 points are then always deducted from any hit. I don't know about blight or bleed, and I'm sure those are not blocked, but any physical attack that would deal, say, 20 damage has 10 damage reduced from it. So, you know, unlike the, let's say, Crusader's ability that gives, I think, 5 to Torch at level 1. 5 to Torch and, what is it, 10 or 20% protection. Oh my god. Damn. That hit hard. 20% protection here, you lose down to the Torch. The Torch getting added to it, but you get this whole... What's it called? Guard ally benefit. Let's see what activates repost is. Repost. I'm so sorry if I'm spelling it incorrectly. Maybe I'm going to actually guess maybe it's like a taunt, because it adds protection. So maybe it'll make this target attack him, or it's a self. Yeah, okay. Marked, and I know none of them have any marking abilities, so maybe he marks himself so they attack him and then he attacks them back. I'm not sure yet. Let's attack their back line, try to take him out.
Decimated.
Oh, that's a phenomenal crit.
Yes.
Let's go ahead and snuff the storage out.
Darkness closes in, haunting the hearts of men.
Because, you know, I could really, if I have this much manual control over the Torch, I could actually really abuse, unless they say something to the extent of rewards will be equivalent of the amount that the Torch was at the beginning of the fight. I could definitely see a lot of abuse in terms of reducing the Torch to zero right before the last hit, getting a massive amount of items.
This expedition at least promises.
See, these
success.
Aren't the greatest treasures, but I think in terms of crests and deeds and what are these again? Busts. statues, whatever you want to call them. Here, you seem to have good luck with those. Okay, fear of the unholy. See, so now I actually got a negative quirk, and okay, this is good.
If only treasure could staunch the flow of otherworldly
corruption. Alright, so let's go ahead and use some torches, make some room, and continue our trek down this corridor. So far, I don't recall having any combat in any of the rooms, so considering that the purpose of this mission is to complete all the room battles, technically speaking, I had no reason to go to those rooms if I could scout them ahead and see that there were no enemies inside of them. And this is exactly what I was talking about. Now, that was actually a really good find with rather high light, but right now, I need to make room, so I'm gonna actually get rid of the gold, because that is not 1500 yet. At this battle, I'll have this other battle in the room, and I'll go ahead and camp that one. So I'll be able to go through some of this food, some more of the firewood, and open up more room in my inventory. Now, he's missing 6, he's missing 9. It's a good deal. Okay, not bad. God, that hits just, she hits so damn hard. The only difference here is that if they could bleed, this will be the superior ability, and this is the superior ability if you're going for crits, which there's really no reason not to at this point. Because if it bleeds, is an incredibly powerful ability when it comes down to bigger enemies. I still don't think I've had really a chance to see what I gotta look up the correct pronunciation. Repost. Again, sorry if I'm butchering it.
A trifling victory, but a victory nonetheless.
I think I packed a little bit too much food, but again, it's not a big deal. There's a lot of light here, and I didn't bother to take any anti-venom. Oh my. Anti-venom, now! I don't have any! Stop yelling! So it's good to know that the ability doesn't have to be hit for him to mark himself and add I'll just call it the R effect. And that was a critical 6 heal, so he healed every 3 and then crit. Wait, oh my gosh, I just realized I'm not one of those people that see the bleed chance and flip out, because I realize that they have their own bleed resistances. Each one of these heroes have their own bleed resistances, and those bleed resistances increase as they level up. I am fully aware of the fact now that if he hits a high-end, like, max level heal, so he heals for like 20 and he crits, he could heal for 40, and if he has any trinkets or quirks that increase his healing abilities, we're talking about like a 60 or a 50 heal, which is just mind-boggling, really.
They can be beaten.
So that is definitely going to be a sight to see. Let's go ahead, snuff out the torches. Holds
much worse okay, so
heirloom chest I know has a secret compartment. Huzzah. Okay, and I threw those away because I thought I wouldn't get more. That's 750 gold right here, so this will max out at 4, I think. So if I do need another slot for 1500 gold, I will get rid of these for sure. It's gold, whatever. Go ahead, camp.
A spark without kindling.
Let's feast.
It's a goal.
We all know I have way more than enough. Feed them a little. Open up another slot. Okay, let's take a look. I'm not going to be encountering a 20%. Size 2 monsters, seeing as this is a level 1 dungeon. He needs a stress reduction. Let's go ahead and do this. What's he got? 12% dodge for himself. Oh my goodness. That's a damn good buff. Alright, so none of them have any. Damn it. None of them have actual stress reduction. So I'm just gonna go ahead and give him insanely high resistance to stress. 50% stress resist, I think, would be more than enough to keep him from reaching that 100 threshold, because I really don't want to have to pay for any sort of rehabilitation for these heroes.
And now, the darkness holds dominion.
If this is the case, I may as well just reduce it to 0. Oh mama. Oh mama. I didn't see it coming. That was phenomenal.
Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer.
Oh cool. So even though I snuffed out the torch, because it was an ambush and the torch hasn't technically had a chance to reignite. Okay, I need to go. Oh, cool, you can crit on that too. Wait, if I recall, okay, never mind. I recall falsely. I'm not scared of using those, honestly. I think that the benefits outweigh the risks. But you know, some people may disagree, and I will not blame them by any means.
Oh man, with impunity.
I should rotate their slots when I get a chance. They add stress and the spiders light.
As victories mount,
see,
so
these
too
are
will
what
resistance.
I'm looking for. Rubies, sapphires. Let's go ahead and get rid of torches. Swap area spots with her so she could use Iron Swan on the back line. Oops, my bad. Alright, looks good. Alright, good. Now I can scout. I can see if I need to go here. Do I want to go to that? Oh, fuck. I don't have a shovel for that. What are my trap percentages? 20, 10, 30. Yeah, okay, let's go here. Actually, Well, yeah, I mean, there's a trap, I know where it is, and in terms of food, I should be okay here. I got rid of my, herbs, or whatever.
Finding the stuff 20%. Is only the first test. Now it must be carried home.
That is actually not bad at all. Well, at least for this particular situation, considering that they are not particularly buff and very healthy. Their maximum HP is really low, so it's not inconceivable at all to see them falling to 25% or lower. Okay, one thing I should definitely do is, so that I avoid taking additional stress damage,
as the light gains
I have
purchase,
to have
spirits
full
are lifted,
light levels when I encounter
made
this.
Clear.
I think I will send my occultist into affliction here.
Without tools of iron, you must rely on flesh, an indefatigable purpose.
50% resistance, that's insane. Oh my god, 50 gold? That's fantastic! Oh, okay, so earlier when I said that... That's red now, that's nice. Earlier when I said that they shouldn't encounter any size 2 enemies just shows how stupid and ignorant I am, etc, etc. Him. Right, so mark doesn't necessarily mean that all attacks are guaranteed to go on him. If that worked, that function would actually be getting an enemy marked. I mean, now I marked would absolutely destroy that particular unit. But I don't think. Ever, while Riposte is active, I've seen him get hit yet, so that is definitely something to see. Oh man, a 2 health crit, that's just fantastic. I mean, really? Come on, I have a marked unit here, and these enemies in a level 1 dungeon are focusing this hero down. That is just insane.
A hand's breadth from
now he's
becoming
definitely
unwound.
Gonna go here, huh? No? Yes. Why can't I feed him? What happened? I cannot... I don't have bandages, but luckily he's not bleeding anymore, which is nice. Is he guaranteed to die next turn? Yes. I did not need to click you. Come on, the one time where bleeding him would put him in a bad scenario. And luckily, I think I can still feed. Yeah, he's not on death's door, so I should,
littering gold, trinkets
should
and
be
baubles,
able to feed him.
Paid for in blood.
No, oh, I do have bandages. Okay. Awesome. sweet. Alright, this is good actually. I forgot it heals, I would have given it to him. Crap. Whatever. Alright, at least I made it to where he won't go bonkers anytime soon. This is new. This is very, very new. It says the sacrifice of fire is the gate to ruin. Place a torch if you crave the void. Do I crave the void?
Secrets and wonders can be found in the most tenebrous corners of
this place. So regretting doing that. Holy crap. Okay, and I cannot ring. Our torches are fully ablaze. Bullshit. I'm so fucked. There's no dodge. Okay, plus 15 damage against Eldritch. Yes! That. Actually. Oh. I was about to say that didn't do jack, but. I'm not happy about this in the least bit. I've never seen these units before. He is critting a lot. I wonder if there are quicks and trinkets to add crit percentage to healing. That would actually be kind of cool to see. Oh yeah, that was a big crit. Oh mama, that was nice. Oh, that's why. Dealt no damage. Okay, actually that does deal quite a bit of damage. Damn. Alright, let's see. You know, let's just focus him down. Let's be realistic here. 23% chance of it. Please, no! Oh my gosh, I just realized this affects the whole party. I'm so stupid. I am so stupid. Yes, please. Light me with your poison sacks. I don't even know what that is. I don't want to know what that is.
What are we doing? I'm a crybaby.
And now the true test. Hold fast or expire.
I'm not gonna bother with these. I'm going to hope that, just like with the bosses, we kill the quote-unquote boss, that, I realized I should've used a bandage on him. Come on, man! Damn! I'm gonna hope that that one health is going to, protect him from dying. He'll just go to death's door and help protect him from any damage that they'll deal. Fingers crossed. All right.
Perched at the very precipice.
That's not good.
Of oblivion.
Yes. Okay. Cool. The guard pretty much means he'll block for him for this turn. I can see Man-At-Arms being selfish. Great.
Self-preservation is paramount. At any cost.
Can I get good heal for once? What are these heals? I crit for one, I crit for two. I haven't seen any heal higher than, I think, what, six? Something like that? Damn. talk about unlucky.
Teetering on the brink, facing the abyss.
Oh, yeah, let's hurt myself when I'm already at death's door. That's just phenomenal. Damage.
Prodigious size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade. Dazed, reeling, about to break.
Not good.
Fear and frailty finally claim
their due. I think we're going to have to abandon this
injury
quest.
And despondence set the stage for heroism.
I mean, this in itself is like a mini quest within the frickin' dungeon to begin with. Oh, look, a good heal bonus. Thank you. She gave up on her turn. Yeah, this is definitely not a frickin'
those who covet injury
mission.
Find it
that
in no short supply.
Right. What? Why? Why do you have these buffs on you? Holy mother. What? Oh my god. I bit off so much more than I could chew. And I'm not going to turn on the torches right now, because if I am going to get something good. I should have blocked for her, actually. What's absurd to me is I have not been healing him, but he is just one tanky mofo, and that is honestly impressive. Okay, that was a good freaking hit. Three protection just means that these buggers get three damage reduced for each one of my hits. I see heart attacks on the horizon. Damn it. This kind of really sucks. He dies from a heart attack, and now he's gonna die from a heart attack. No. Oh, great, I can't heal myself anymore. I just want the treasure, man. I just want the treasure. At this point, I don't care about this party. It's a level 1 party. Everyone except for the Highwaymen. At level 1. At level 0, I mean. This is so frustrating.
This is no place for the weak or the foolhardy.
I killed the boss, and these things get buffed to all hell.
But not the end of things.
Well, now I've learned, and unfortunately, everything I've collected is gone. God.
My obsession caused this great foulness.
Jeez. Mistakes were made, man. Mistakes were made. Damn. Alright, now I have the Arbalest available.
But his eyes hold the secrets of 100 campaigns.
Right, ranged enemy, what's this? Rallying flare torch. Okay, so this clears. I can't tell if this is for both units or just where she could cast it from or onto who, I'm not sure. Let's see, look at this, it says she could cast it. Okay, so I'm gonna say that this is for a single target. Yeah, it says target, right? I'm honestly not sure. We'll have to see. Let's blind for a random target. Add speed. Deal some damage. Damn, that's not bad at all, actually. Oh my gosh, 20% heal received? Wait. That's plus. Okay, so that just increases the amount of healing that that particular target receives. That's actually pretty damn good support ability. Mark target, okay. Affects the back line, back three positions of the enemy. Not bad. Wow, that's actually pretty damn good. Okay.
Make no mistake, we will face ever greater threats. Our soldiers must be ready. The bellows blast once again. The forge stands ready to make weapons of war.
Alright, who do I want to take with me? I'm going to actually go ahead and wrap the video up here, and I'm just going to go ahead and start another video so that this video doesn't seem too damn long, because there's going to be a lot of looking around their abilities and trying to decide who I want to upgrade with my very limited amount of gold, considering that, if you remember correctly, the last dungeon run that we did, I ended up spending a ton of gold on all the items, and I had a lot of goodies in my inventory, but unfortunately I lost every single one of my units because I wanted to see what the hell I'd get for I just realized how incredibly challenging that monster that I summoned will be in like a level 6 or 7 dungeon. The thought of it's just scary, because level 1 dungeon I spawned a 77 health monster, which I think is stronger than most bosses at the moment, so at like level 1 bosses, so you know, I think level 7 dungeons could be like what, 200-300 health? God, it's insane. So anyway, there's gonna be a lot of looking around of who I want to heal. I don't know if I want to really make her my main healer, because it means that I'll have to unlock and then upgrade these abilities, and I'll have to treat her, which might just take too long, which honestly at that point I'm better off just doing some sort of a short run with a group of really tanky heroes that don't need any healing really in a short run. So I think I'll just take these four into a short run. But again, I'll do all of that in the next video, so I appreciate you watching. This is the first video of what I hope to be many very entertaining videos, and I appreciate you putting up with me. I realize that I'm by no means an expert in commentating while I'm playing. I get distracted, or I may lose track or go on a tangent. So thank you very much for watching. If you like the video, please hit like and subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more of this content. And I hope to see you soon. Have a good one. Bye bye.